Hey everybody, and welcome to today's video with myself, Sarah Lean. What I want to show you today is how you can use GitHub Desktop to clone a repository to your local machine. So the first thing you have to do is click on File and then Clone Repository. Now when you open this, you get a dialog box that gives you a few options about how you want to clone a repository. So the first option I want to walk you through is cloning via a URL. So if we head over to GitHub, we can see here we've got this repository called the WinGet CLI repository. And I'm going to grab the URL for that. So I click on code and then copy this HTTPS address, the URL. I'm going to then switch back to GitHub Desktop and I'm going to paste that URL here. And what you'll notice here is that the local path has created a new file for me, or a new folder, sorry. And that's going to clone that repository into this new folder path. So if we click on clone, depending on the size of the repository, it may take a few minutes for the files to download and refresh for you, but eventually you will then have a copy of that repository on your machine. Now you'll see here again, we've got a couple of options that we can select. If we want to work on the files, we can click on Open in Visual Studio Code, which is my default editor, or we could open up the Explorer and see the files specifically. I'm going to open up Visual Studio Code and just show you what that looks like. So you can see here, I've just opened up Visual Studio Code and it's opened it into that repository for me, so I can start to work on the files and make changes and create new branches, etc. Now, if we go back into GitHub Desktop, if we wanted to clone a repository that's already associated with our account, we click on File and Clone Repository and we select the option of github.com. Now this will show me all the repositories that are already forked inside my account on github.com, so I can then take a copy of that repository onto this local machine. So for example, I have a repository here called Ambassador Resources, so I'm going to click on that. And again, the local path has created this folder for me so that the files are copied to that path for me. And again, if I click on clone, after a few minutes or a few seconds, it has copied that local repository down for me. And again, I have the option here to open inside Visual Studio Code, show in the Explorer, or even visit the files on GitHub themselves. Now, the last option inside this clone repository section is around GitHub Enterprise. So if your organization, or if you have a GitHub Enterprise account, you can sign in and get access to the files there and just go through the cloning process, just the same as we have done for the other two options. Thank you for tuning into this video, folks. It's short and sweet, just showing you some of the features inside GitHub Desktop, but hopefully I'll catch you inside another video. Thanks, folks.